Right now, thanks to a challenge gift, your donation to CitizenLink can effectively be doubled. $50 can have the impact of $100. Just click on the banner on CitizenLink.com.
Can a state tell a Christian adoption agency to betray their beliefs? This is the CitizenLink Report. Hi, I'm Kim Troby. The 2014 midterms were good for conservative values, but that doesn't mean that those who push an agenda of multiple genders and sexual orientations is going away. And that means adoption agencies will have to protect themselves and the children they serve. Bill Blackwire is with Bethany Christian Services in Michigan, and I had the chance to speak to him recently.
And it's not about who may adopt or who should adopt or who even does the best adoptions. It's rather about faith-based agencies should have the right to operate based on their strongly held religious beliefs. My life mission, which is also Bethany's, is feeling strongly about making sure that children are well cared for and that all children have a permanent loving family. And I believe if Bethany would cease doing its services, it would be a tremendous loss to children, families, and, of course, the community in the world where we live.
CitizenLink works with 38 associated family policy councils across the country, including the Michigan Family Forum. Brad Snavely is executive director of the group, and he and I spoke recently about legislation that will be introduced in the state.
Several years ago, we started working with state representatives and state senators on legislation that would provide a clear right of conscience for faith-based adoption agencies in Michigan. And your listeners may or may not be aware of the fact that almost half of all foster care adoptions are conducted with the help of a faith-based adoption agency, whether it's Catholic Social Services or our friends at Bethany Christian Services or many others. And so the state really relies on these faith-based agencies to conduct this very important public role here, this public purpose, which is to find homes for these kids, forever families for these kids in foster care. And so what we're finding is with the definition of the family, the definition of marriage sort of being up for grabs, literally, in society today, that can put at risk the ability of a faith-based agency really to conduct this good work according to their founding principles, as you said. So we're hopeful that the legislature will act quickly here in the next couple of weeks in Michigan to ensure that no matter what happens with the definition, the legal definition of marriage and the family, that these groups will be free to practice and do the good work that they want to do without violating their founding principles.
Now, tell me real quick why you have such a short window of time to get this accomplished.
We're at the very tail end of a two-year legislative session, which means that all the bills that have been introduced over the last 2 years are going to be debated or possibly could be debated and passed in this next two-year window. And those that are not passed and sent to the governor for his signature or veto have to be reintroduced after January 1. And so this bill has started in the process, and we'd like to see that process finished. We'd like to see these bills put before the governor before the end of 2014. And so we're having a very big push here to make sure that legislators understand how important this issue is. And we just appreciate your listeners and viewers, getting up to speed on this and perhaps taking the time to voice their opinion with their state rep or state senator here in Michigan.
Now, Brad, tell our viewers why this is so important. They may not understand the issues behind such protections. Nobody wants to discriminate against someone, but Christians don't want to be discriminated against either.
Right. And, religious freedom is for all of us, right? And we're in a very tolerant and open society. Everyone knows that. This is not an attempt to deny a service to anyone, but it is an attempt to say for those agencies that are engaged in this work, it would be so wrong. It'd be contrary to our founding principles of America to say you either compromise your beliefs about your view of marriage and the family in order to continue doing this good work with the state. In other words, we should have great diversity. In fact, this bill supports great diversity because we ought to have great diversity in the number and the type of adoption agencies that are serving the people of Michigan. And so what this bill would do, it would be to protect all of the conscience and the founding principles of all the adoption agencies in Michigan to make sure that they don't have to change their founding principles in order to continue to do this good work. And I think we've seen examples around the country, Kim, in other states where these faith-based adoption agencies have actually had to make that tough choice, and some have decided to discontinue that good work rather than compromise on such a foundational principle as their view of the family. And so we want to make sure that no agency in Michigan has to make that choice. And so we just believe that these bills are very important for that reason. We know that the U.S. Supreme Court may be hearing a case, in fact, the Michigan case, involving the definition of marriage within the next couple of years. And so the time is right, and the time is essential, really, to pass this year.
Where can our Michigan viewers go to help and to take action on this?
Well, they could certainly visit our website, michiganfamily.org, and we will have information there on these bills and how they can get involved, either calling their state rep or their state senator and urging them to support this legislation as it moves through the process in the next 2 weeks.
Brad Snavely is with the Michigan Family Forum. It's one of CitizenLink's 38 Associated Family Policy Councils. And Brad, we just want to say how much we appreciate you and the work that you do there for the state of Michigan.
Well, and we appreciate you at CitizenLink. And thank you so much for having me on today, Kim.
Thanks to Brad Snavely and to all our Associated Family Policy Councils. If you'd like to find one in your state, just go to citizenlink.com. And thanks to all of you who have written to share your thoughts and encouragement. You can always let us know what you're thinking at mail@citizenlink.com. That's mail@citizenlink.com. And as always, stand tall and be heard.